importance. We talk about bhav. Some of you have heard that word, be in the bhav, that devotional aspect of what kirtan is. And that is an internal experience, and it's not something that's just, okay, people, you know, bhav, we talk about bhav, we throw that word around a lot, right? It's not some new age thing, you know, that you have to wear a tie-dye shirt and talk about being in the bhav. That works too, it's fun. This bhav is something that is so profound that it can actually melt you. And when one of the senior teachers in my tradition, he was making a joke about this idea of power yoga, and someone came up to him once and said, Swamiji, what is power yoga? And he said, let me tell you what power yoga really is. He said, it's when you go up to someone and they're so angry that they want to destroy you. They want to destroy everything about you. And when they come within a few feet of you, of your presence, then it melts away. They no longer feel that. And that is that bhav, that energy that can transform that which is ugly into something that is beautiful. So everything that we do in the yoga tradition is to aim us towards that place, that bliss inside, that place that is to really be who we really are, that bliss, that energy. So this next chant is one that we used to do with my teacher. It was one of the favorite ones he had. Hare Krishna Govinda Mohan Murari. A lot of the same words. If you don't know what we're saying, you can just say Hare Krishna over and over. And God really doesn't care what you say. It's the intention of what you're doing with. Maybe he really does, or she really does care what you say, but we don't care here, so. Hare Krishna Govinda Mohan Murari, and then we'll say Mohan Murari. Mohan Murari, the idea is we're singing to that divine, and the Mohan is that one that entices you inside. Krishna, I know a lot of you have heard about Krishna, and you've, you know, seen some of the things in the airports in the old days and whatnot, but Krishna is actually from the word Krishtihi, which is to love, and that idea that when we are truly loving something, that we're drawn to it. We can't help but be drawn into it. So let yourself just sink into that bhav with this chant.